Okay, this next one is going to be for the YouTube channel Pagan Steve, and his name is Steve, and we're going to go with the nucleus of his soul. Okay, the nucleus, first of all, he has had someone around him, but they're come and go, but is it his soul? The original soul that incarnated in his body. Has he had a walk-in? No? Okay, it's his soul. His soul from the very beginning. Okay, so his soul from the very beginning, and we're going to go to that soul, and that soul has it in him as a, I'm not sure what this is. Hold on a second, Steve. It's a, define it as an adult. Okay, so you did make it as an adult. What I'm seeing is this, it's like an alligator, but it's more like one of those Komodo dragons. I'm thinking it's more like, it's reptilian, but ancient is what they're saying. Very ancient. And I'm trying to see, because you showed me that, now you showed me this. Is it, they said just say reptilian because they're not seeing it. It must have been, like in the, you know, the evolution of things, it's changed a lot. So yeah, they would say this was just something that was way back when. That's what's coming off your soul. So you went from being a little lizard looking thing to this big thing, and you have, was he a water creature or a land creature or both? They see you in water. They see you in land. You were both. They see you in a swampy area. Swampy in, they're not even seeing the landmass. Is it from this planet? Yeah, okay, it's this planet. And okay, so the landmass must have changed because I'm not even seeing the landmass. I would say probably from my own instincts of things, Steve, it's probably in the South Africa region. That's where I'm really being pulled more to, okay? It's difficult when you have a soul consciousness of a creature as opposed to a human being because you don't know where you are at. You know, you're just doing your thing. And so that's understandable. So they would have to go with all the emotional energy out there at the time of your soul consciousness to see if they can find out what might be going on around you at that time. So it takes a little bit of knowing what they're doing to understand, and it can be a little bit confusing at times. But anyway, so basically your soul was there for a while, and you took good care of yourself. You didn't put up with a lot of stuff, you know, not even from your own species, because I see that you look like you're snapping at a few of them a few times as if to say get away. Basically a pretty even, mostly even type of attitude. Don't mess with me, I don't mess with you kind of thing. You just kind of like laid around, enjoyed your life, enjoyed the sun, enjoyed the surroundings, ate when you were hungry, knew how to forage your food. And in this particular time, I really don't even see people around, and just a lot of other beings like you and other animal type beings. But yeah, you just pretty much laid back, easy going, don't mess with me, I won't mess with you, that kind of attitude. And there for a long time. Very, very long time, they're saying. And anything else for Steve? Just that you knew how to take care of yourself. You were very observant too. I'm looking at you now as that creature, and I can see you really looking around, really observing things, but kind of like I'm observing but chilling at the same time. You know, I'm seeing what's going on, I'm checking it out, nothing looks like it's out there to get me, so I'm going to lay back and take a break. But you have that instinct that said, if someone comes after me, you know, I'll know it, and they're in deep doo-doo, if they do, okay? So that's what I'm feeling. You pretty much knew how to take good care of yourself back then, and that's why you were there for a long time. Anything else? Everybody say, nope, that'll do it. All right, hope you enjoyed it. Bye-bye.